Have you ever dreamt of going to overseas to study at a renowned university? Yes? Then you are one of many other Indian students who have been working their entire life towards that one dream. But what many students don't realize is that the process is very long and every step in that process is very, very important. One such important step where many people get stuck is while filling out the application form to colleges. You also might find yourself stuck and helpless while preparing your application form to your favorite college because of this one section called Statement of Purpose. So I'm here today to help you out with that one step, to help you write the perfect statement of purpose to your favorite college, popularly known as SOP. Also, we have talked about the entire study abroad process step by step in one of the videos, which you can check on our channel. This video is specific to SOP, the most important part of your application. Tips for writing an effective statement of purpose. Have you ever thought about why universities in Australia, USA, UK, Canada, New Zealand, Ireland, and other overseas countries need SOPs? And what exactly does your SOP tell them about you? Let's figure that out first. Why SOPs? Universities abroad require you to submit your application with a statement that talks about your career path and goals. This helps universities gain confidence on your candidature before they select your application. A statement of purpose, also known as a letter of intent, is written to admission panel of the universities and constitute details about your career path, interests, professional contribution, goals, and the driving force behind pursuing a particular program. This is usually submitted in a form of an essay. However, some universities have question-based SOPs. It is the most important part of your application that decides your admission to your preferred institution. I must tell you that a well-written SOP paints your overall personality for the universities looking at enrolling you. It serves as an opportunity to convince the admission committee why they should choose you over other applicants. In fact, it has been seen that a good SOP works great for weak academic profiles, wherein you can compensate by highlighting your future goals and ambitions. A well-written SOP also highlights your writing skills as it reflects how well you can express your thoughts. So before you sit down to write, there are some do's and don'ts you must consider while writing an exemplary SOP to convince universities that you're not another run-of-the-mill and regular candidate. Here are the components of a good SOP in a nutshell. Here are the three major steps you need to keep in mind while writing your SOP. Plan it well. Create an outline of your SOP and work accordingly. Share a story that developed your interest in your subject in a good way to build your introduction. Create pointers and categories. List down your relevant achievements and expertise. And most importantly, your reason behind choosing the course and the university. Work on the draft. Focus on sharing your learnings and knowledge during your education and industry experience. If there is a gap or an academic issue, address them in an optimistic manner. Make sure your SOP has a clear introduction and conclusion. Remember, you should always write your SOP in a reverse chronological order. Review before you send. It's important to review what you've written. Reanalyzing will help you correct the flow, vocabulary, sentence construction errors, long sentences, and other grammar issues. Get a second opinion, maybe from your professor, senior, or an IDP expert. Make sure you proofread properly and double-check before submission. Here are the do's and don'ts in a nutshell. The do's, useful tips. Keep it original. Make sure that your SOP has an interesting beginning and an inspiring end. Most importantly, it has to be original. Do not copy someone else's SOP. No quotes or quotations, please. It has to be original. Focus on your goals. If you're applying for postgraduate or higher courses, you should focus on elaborating on your academic backgrounds, research, and future goals. But if you're applying for an undergraduate course, you should focus more on your short-term goals and career inclination in your SOP. What are your goals and interests? Your SOP should speak about your purpose of education, referring to your past, present, and future. There has to be connecting links and clear mention of goals and interests. Are you in the right place? Upon reading your SOP, the admission committee should be able to understand how you can add value and contribute to the university in terms of research and future scope in that chosen area. Make sure that you always browse through the university website thoroughly to ensure that you fit well for the program and meet the eligibility criteria before applying. Use the active voice. Lastly, always write your SOP in an active voice. Your writing must convey information in a manner that reflects your positive mindset and passion. If you have any statements or references, try quoting them with the relevant examples rather than being direct. These are just some points you should keep in your mind while writing your application. Yet, if you feel that you're stuck somewhere or you're unable to figure out how you should do it, you can always contact your IDP expert and they can help you through it. Please remember, all IDP counseling services are free of charge. You can walk up to your closest IDP office and ask them to guide you with your SOP. Also, you can connect with our expert online. Now, let's look at some common mistakes and things you must avoid. Don'ts, common mistakes. Stay within the word limit. Make sure you keep your SOP within the specified word limit and do not go overboard. Specified format, font size, and template, make sure you follow it all. Customize and modify. Don't use the same SOP for all the applications. Change it to fit specific university requirements. Avoid TMI, too much information. Refrain from mentioning personal and family information and situations as these are irrelevant in an SOP. Scores are repetitive. You should not mention scores of your IELTS, SAT, GRE, GMAT, etc. as these are already your application components. Avoid the common and copy. You should avoid using overly common phrases, copied information, and content picked from websites. Do not plagiarize. There are many softwares which catches plagiarism. So never forget this because it may spoil your entire submission even if you are the brightest of the students. Have clarity in your writing. Don't make your SOP sound empty, vague, blank, or meaningless. Make sure you provide facts, reasons, or example wherever possible. Be a believer, not a dreamer. You must make sure that you write in a positive manner that shows you are not a dreamer but a firm believer who has clarity of your future goals. SOPs are majorly rejected due to poor correlation from the beginning to the end. Do not write in a manner that comes across as pleading. Words like thinking, believing, and feeling usually put off admissions committee. Abide by the truth. Never hide any information or give wrong facts in your SOP. What do universities expect? What do they want? Top 5 things your university expects in your SOP. Keep your language positive, precise, and free from grammatical errors. Use active voice. Highlight unique qualities that demonstrate your interest and goals. Mention how your talent, interests, or experience will contribute to the institution. Talk about your motivation to pursue a particular course at the university. Use examples to validate your pointers. We know the do's and don'ts, but how do we know what the universities want? What do they expect of you? Universities always expect students to reflect a positive attitude in their writing, which should not have any grammatical errors. Your unique qualities are something universities look forward to nourishing, and they want to find out how your talents and experience will contribute to the institution. Above all this, expressing your motivation to pursue a particular course is much appreciated. Like I said earlier, every step in an application process is important and crucial. Universities will look at your application holistically and not selectively on the basis of your SOPs. So make sure you give it your all. But that is not something you should be worrying about because international education experts from IDP are well versed with the whole application process and can help you in drafting a great SOP. We will help you sail through the process smoothly. Admission process and preparing your application form to your dream institution is a very overwhelming process. Therefore, before you send off your application, make sure you plan well, work on your draft, never plagiarize, write about yourself quantitatively, and review the document thoroughly. And as always, IDP is always there for you to guide you in your study abroad process. If you have the dream, we will show you the way. Don't forget to subscribe to IDP YouTube channel for more insight on study abroad.